Now see that beta, again I am making a number line which represent integers. I am making 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 or 8. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 or minus 8. Now I have made this number line. Okay, now suppose I am having question 5 minus 12. Okay, this is suppose we have given problem. This time we are going to solve with the number line. First of all, we just solve according to the rules. Okay, one is positive number, the number in which is not having any sign in front of this always have plus sign. If in the given question 5 is not having any sign in front, means this is positive number. Two opposite sign numbers are always subtracted. They are two opposite sign. Just write in a bracket for understanding two opposite sign number. And what was the rule you have written? You can follow their two opposite sign number. We have written that two opposite sign numbers are always subtracted. Okay, they will be subtracted. So subtract then 12 minus 5, 7, and with greater number sign, greater number is minus 7. Okay. Now we will do this question with the help of number line. Just stand on 5. And what I told you, for subtraction we will go in this direction and for addition we will go in this direction. Means in this direction subtraction will be performed. Or in forward direction we will perform addition. This time we have to perform subtraction. We will come in this direction. Stand on 5. Here 5 is there. And what you have to subtract? 12. Count. Here I am standing. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Where you are reaching? You reached on minus 8. And this is our result. Understanding or not? Again, one more question I am doing with this help. This number line. 7 plus, not 7. Minus 3 plus 8. Okay. Minus 3 plus 8. They have two opposite sign. And what we have, two opposite sign numbers are always subtracted. Means 8 minus 3 will be 5. And with greater number sign. Means plus 5. Now stand on minus 3. Here minus 3 is there. And plus 8 means for addition we will move in a forward direction. I made arrow here. You can understand from here. Now stand on minus 3 and count now 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Where you reach? 5. In this way you can get the result. And many more questions are given in your book also. You can do from there. And you have done all these questions in class 6th also. Okay. Now we are going to learn the properties of integers. Okay. We are going to learn properties of integers. In this way you can solve many questions. Just take the, if you will not have book, I will share book in your WhatsApp group so that you will not have any problem. Don't worry, just follow whatever we are giving or taking your class. Do seriously, learn seriously at your home so that you may understand, and whatever doubt you will have, you can place your put your doubt in my WhatsApp number. I will solve your doubt. Now properties of addition and subtraction of integers. Properties of addition and subtraction of integers. We are having 4 to 5 properties for addition and subtraction. I am writing in this way. In one column I will do for addition, and for another column I will do for subtraction. See that. First one is closure property. Closure property says that if A and B are integers, then A plus B will also be an integer. And for subtraction also, if A and B are integers, then A minus B will be integer. See that. Suppose I am having 2 and 8, and if I will write 2 plus 8 will also belong to 10. 10 comes in number line in right hand side directions. You are having number line, you can see from there also. We can increase the number line according to our convenience. Okay, and suppose A and B are integers, 2 and 8, again see that 2 and 8 are integers, then 2 minus 8, 2 opposite sign number always subtracted, so 8 minus 2, 6 with greater number sign, minus 6 also belongs integers, in this way, it means addition is closed. What we are writing? Addition is closed for integers, and here we will write addition is closed for subtraction. Closed means they are satisfying the closure property. Closed mean doesn't understand that you will not understand that closed mean that is not the meaning of closed. It means addition integers will satisfy the closure property, and here subtraction is closed for integer. What I will write? Subtraction is closed for integers. Okay, means if A and B are any two integers we have taken, then A plus B, whatever result come, that will also belong to the integer. In the same way, if A and B are integers, then A minus B will also belongs to the integers. Means whatever result will come, that will also belongs to the integer. This is your first property. Then second property is commutative property. Commutative property says that if A and B are any two integers, then A plus B is equal to B plus A. Means if we will change, if we will add the two integers, or when we will change their values also, then there will be no change in their result. Means A plus B and B plus A will always remain same. For example, see that we have 2 or 7. If we have A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 7, then according to A plus B means 2 plus 7 is equal to B means 7, a plus 2, 2 plus 7, 9 is equal to 9. Here A plus B will be equal to B plus A. Now see the second property for integers, commutative property. In this commutative property, these are same properties we are in left hand side we are satisfying for the addition, and in right hand side we are satisfying for the subtraction. Now see that A minus B not equal to B minus A. Suppose we are having same numbers, I am taking A is equal to what we have 2 minus B is 7. 2 minus 7, see that two opposite sign number, they will be subtracted. 7 minus 2, what it will come? 5. And what greater number sign means? Minus 5. Now see that B means 7 or A means 2, we have taken 7 minus 2, it will be 5. You see that minus 5 and 5, two results are coming. So minus 5 will not be equal to plus 5. So in this way, what we will write? Commutative property will not be satisfied for addition, means A minus B never it can be equal to B minus A. These are two properties. First one is closure property for addition and subtraction. In both the condition, if A and B are two integers, then A plus B will also belongs to the integer. Same way, if A and B are two integers, then A minus B will also belongs to the integers. Okay, now second one is commutative property. If A and B are integers, then A plus B, according to the commutative property, what is that? A plus B is equal to B plus A, means if we will change the value places of the numbers, then the result also be same. See that if I have taken A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 7, then 2 plus 7 is equal to 7 plus 2. According to this rule, we have put the value here in the given means condition. Then 7 plus 2 is also 9, and 2 plus 7 is also 9. So 9 is equal to 9. But for subtraction, commutative property cannot be satisfied. If A minus B not equal to B minus A. A minus B means 2 minus 7 is equal to, here I have written is equal to 7 minus 2. If you can see that 2 minus 7 will come minus 5 and 7 minus 2 will come 5. So minus 5 and 5, they cannot be equal. They are not equal. So in this way, we have seen two properties, closure property and commutative property. And we are having three more properties.